How's everybody doing tonight, everybody? How's everybody doing? How's everybody? I'll be George, your dog trainer, your canine behavior specialist for the evening, you know. How many of us, by show of hands, how many of y'all in here got canines? How many of y'all got dogs? That's it, that's all? Y'all don't love the animals? Come down there and put the leash on you and get you to walk straight. By the time I'm through with you, we'll have you walking a blind lady downtown getting her groceries. Have you certified. You know, I never forget my first dog, you know. All I had was my belt. Was a Rottweiler, mangy as hell, with ticks on his neck and a little bit of the, where the neck, where the leash had, you know, neglected. They had the leash street people owned her. All right. And she had the neck where it wore into the neck, looked like, you know, a shitty vagina all the time. The scar never healed, you know. Named them Balls Out, you know. We named the dog Balls Out because when they tried to fix them themselves, his little balls hang out by themselves with no skin. Look like two cherries. You know, I got a lot of tips for everybody out there. Yeah, but breeding the dogs, all right, and you get them going and, you know, they get locked up. You get locked up and they can't pop out. You ever need to get it out there, you just get a little bit of salt and sprinkle it on this pink thing and it'll shrink up like a slug. It'll pop right out, you can separate it that way. You know, I just told him he got a pocket full of gosh and I just taught a big old glass. You know. Sometimes I come home and, you know, a lot of people want to know, what do I do when the dog's begging, all right? Okay. And the dog, you sit down on your chair and you're eating your meal and the dog's in front begging. You know, what we do in my class is we put a little Tabasco in their eyes, all right? And make them see the truth. They don't want to eat that food. It's going to, you know, it's going to burn their inside and make them shit. Okay. You know, we put a little Tabasco in their yard. Make it feel right, you know, just squeeze it in there. I never forget the first time, you know, I come to my class and, you got a condi ass in there that don't want to discipline the dog. And you just gotta come down on them hard. I know they're paying you for the money for you to come teach you about the dog, but you can't be no Gandhi ass. You really gotta get in there and just choke the dog. I got a class at like 5 o'clock. You know, David Ledbetter, you know, great at golf, but he can't control his, you know, his pit bull. I got a pit bull club over by Conroy, all right? You know, one of the dogs they have come in, the owner, you know, he don't take care of his dog. It got little angel trumpets fall off the tree. The dog ate the angel trumpets, bit like 4 kids and like 6 police. Hit him with the billy club, you know, the dog looking like, you know, Rodney King, but he's just a little pit bull, you know. I try to shed a little light on this, you know, it's a really, you know, neglected dog over there, you know. You know, I got dabble in the arts, I get into the arts sometime, you know, I did a little art, little graphic design, you know, and I get a little picture of the pit bulls over in New York coming up out of the sewer with like gas and fog and like neon lights and like coming up out of the Hudson River, like, you know. And their farts sometimes is like, you smell them and it's like, you know, it's taking years off your life, like worse than smoking cigarettes. Because it's like, you know, my glass.
Comedy's not from there. We got any dust? Dust? Sprinkle some dust?
Oh,
motherfucker's like a French film. You never know when it's fucking over. You should close up with fin. It fucking leaves you like open ended. It's like, what? Did they fucking kill Butler? What's going on? Why is that guy coming up?